Hey guys, it's Colette here with OutLateButGreat, your host here on the channel for Tuesdays. I hope you guys are doing well. I'm sorry I missed you guys last week. I totally forgot. We were no longer on hiatus. I've been wrapped up in schoolwork. I've been taking 2 summer classes this summer, and my summer's been pretty busy and exciting, and time has been flying by. And even today, I just realized, oh yay, I gotta make a video. And so here I am. Hi. And this week's topic is from Michelle, and she chose one of our viewer topics from Ben. And his topic has to do about dating, specifically older LGBT people. Basically kind of giving advice, like thoughts of being single and older and maybe newly out. So I'm going to try to answer this as best as I can. I didn't actually confer with someone that I know that's older and newly out and part of the LGBT community. A lot of the friends that I have that are in the LGBT community are pretty much partnered up. I do have some friends that are single, and they're trans ladies. And a lot of them actually have had pretty good luck going out and about and dating. And I think a lot of them have joined like meetup groups. And they have social apps on their phone where you can like chat with people, and basically it's the meetups. I think some of them have done some online dating. I would never recommend Craigslist, so no, not with that. As far as like gay and lesbian friends, I have a lot of the trans ladies that I know are actually lesbian identifying. In terms of like my cisgendered friends, a lot of them are partnered up, so don't really have advice from them. But I think if you're newly out and you want to go out and date around and kind of experience the single life, you should definitely go do that and have a great time. But be safe. Don't do Craigslist. Go to meetups. Go to events that you really find interesting, that you're passionate about, because you never know who you can meet in those sorts of settings. There's a little bit more of a complication if you are a trans person, just in terms of having to come to the conclusion if you want to come out to someone or not. And that's usually up to you and your comfort level. Some people I know do it right off the bat just to like get it out of the way. Other people wait, and if they really like somebody, then they might go ahead and reveal that. So it's all on your own discretion. I know if you're newly out, it can be really stressful. Personally, like when I was newly out, I was in a relationship, and I couldn't fathom being single at that point, just because I feel like there's so much going on. Like I don't even feel like I was the best partner at that time, because there's just so much upheaval. And this is just my experience. So it can be very straining on a relationship, and I couldn't imagine trying to start something new. But I know a lot of people do it, and they're successful, and it works really well, and it's kind of a saving grace. So it just all depends on you and your comfort level. But even for me now, like I'm still kind of figuring out who I am and what I want to do. So I can't imagine, I don't know, I kind of feel like it'd be more complicated. But if you have like no other baggage and other hangups, then, you know, go out and have a good time. And if that's all you're looking for, then you'll find it. But if you're looking for like relationships, serious relationships, those sorts of things take time. And, you know, kind of, you almost have to do a lot of work on yourself to make your world what you want it to be as best as you can, so you can kind of attract what you want to attract in such a sense. But I hope I answered this. And I do think you can still meet people at gay bars. I mean, where I live, there's like several gay bars, and I know people who go and meet people. So even if you're older, you can still meet people. So hopefully that helps. If I didn't answer, I'm really sorry. But I hope you guys have a great rest of your week, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.